All right, guys, welcome to the Floating Head Technologies page here. I want to walk you through real quick a little bit about the LogixPro Pro simulator we're going to be using for labs. And before we do this, I want to talk a little bit. I know this is going to be a little bit tricky trying to learn PLCs online, but we're by no means the first group to try to do this. And I think the program that I found is actually going to work out okay. You guys already have about 2 months of PLC experience under your belt, so you're not coming into this fresh. So I'm hoping that this works out. I'm also truly hoping that we can get back on campus in some form so we can get back into the lab and doing some of the things in there. I really, really want us to. It's a super fluid situation, so we're just going to be able to do our, we're going to do our best. So this is the program, the simulation program that I have found that we are going to use. There's a 15-day free trial. Then after that, it's $35. I'm still working pretty hard to get the college to cover that if you can't afford it. If you cannot afford the $35, if you've been laid off and you're worried, don't worry about it. We will absolutely figure something out for you later in the semester, okay? Or we will figure out a way that if you're willing to put the work in, to get you the credit for this class, but more importantly, get you the knowledge that you need to succeed with PLCs at the level you're supposed to be able to when you're done with this class. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. The first thing I want, first, what we want to do is go to Google and type in the learning pit, okay, and Google it. All right. And then go ahead and look for thelearningpit.com. Now, if you want, you can just click on it here, or you could just type in the learning pit right into your browser. Okay? Either way, it's totally fine. Now, they have a number of videos and things like that. Some of them work, some of them don't work. It just kind of depends on where we're at with it. What I want you to do is I want you to go to the Logix Pro Allen Bradley Simulator. Notice there's a 15-day free trial here, okay? Which I think is pretty cool. It doesn't have all of the features. Certain things won't activate, and you can't save anything from what I understand. Again, I'm still kind of learning through this program as we go along. You'd click here, all right? And then go ahead and click the Download Now button, okay? You'd want to click the Download Now button, and it'll allow you to download it. You guys can read through all of this if you want. You guys have seen this before in my PowerPoint, so it shouldn't be too bad. And downloading this is just like downloading any other program. All right. So once you've done that, feel free to go ahead and explore it a little bit. Okay. We're going to be using some of the things from here, some of the labs from here, and we'll kind of go off of what we already had anyway. All right, so let's go ahead. We're going to minimize this browser. And once you've installed it, I would recommend putting a shortcut to your Logic Pro desk. I could try to make a video on how to download this, but we're probably going to be using different versions of Windows, and there's going to be a ton of little different things that are going to make it pretty impossible. Or everything will be a little bit different. So you guys have all probably downloaded something like that. If not, ask a friend to help you out. Or somebody in your house who's computer savvy, but I know you guys are all real good at this stuff. So we're gonna double click the Logic Pro. Now you'll notice here that we still have 10, I have 10 days left. Okay, you will be able to purchase this. You can go ahead and purchase it right away if you think it's something you're gonna be using a lot, but I would recommend giving it a shot for a little bit and just kind of seeing how it all goes. All right, so we'll go ahead and hit continue here. Now you'll notice that this looks very similar to your RS Logix 500 platform. When you open it up, you got a little wizard here who can help. And here are where your simulation world's gonna be, okay? Excuse me, where the all your all that inform all of your different things are gonna be available to you. All of your IO simulators and things like that, the things that are actually similar to that IO simulator that we had in lab. Okay, and so let me go ahead and walk you through how some of this works. All right, so we have a number of different simulation stations up here. You can kind of flip between, Most of them are available to you in the first 15-day free trial. Others aren't, okay? Or those are there for demonstration purposes, but we're going to use the basic ones, all right? So we're going to go back to the IO simulator, and here's something really cool. If you close out your IO simulator, it brings up your project tree right here, just like an RS Logix 500. So if I open up my input, here's my data table file. All right, that's seriously cool. That is seriously, seriously cool. You can open up your output data table file here. You can even switch between them. All right, and so you have your integer file, you have B3s available to you. Okay, now it's not exactly like RS Logix 500, but it's, I can't imagine a program for $35 getting better than this. And I can't find any other thing out there that works. So the fact that this does it so well, I think is super cool. So let's go ahead, and if you close this out, if you hit the X out right here, this will bring back whatever simulator you had open last. Okay, so you still have your workspace here. Everything's gonna work the way it did. Now I wanna show you guys a couple other features here that are really cool. If you come over to your IO simulator, you'll notice that they have slots in them, okay? So this is I:1, so that'd be slot one. Output is in two. Then you have another rung here for the 3, 4, okay? Then you have a BC simulator. We'll see if we use that. It's been a little hit or miss for me so far, but it might still be working because I'm working on the free trial one. This right here is probably one of the coolest features. I think this is really neat. If you right click, okay, you can actually change what type of input it is. So this is a momentary push button, normally open. This is your normally closed. This is a limit switch, normally open. Limit switch, normally closed. Okay, and then just a selector switch, your basic switch. I think this is so cool. So I'm going to walk you through real quick how to set up a start-stop station. And you can kind of show you some of the other features on here. And then after that, we'll get to the... And then after that, we'll kind of wrap this up so you can kind of see how you download it and everything. So we're going to go ahead, start a new rung. Come here, just like you would in... just like you would in RS Logix 500 again. So I'm going to use my start button here, I:1/0. Okay. Now, if I right click on here, I can do some of the same features as before. I can edit the symbol here. So I'll just say start push button here and hit enter. All right. This is going to be a really important feature, this ability to edit it, because this will tell us what we're doing since we're kind of lacking some of the outputs that we usually have, okay? Then I'm gonna go ahead, put a stop button here, and I'm going to type it in again, I:1, oops, you have to double click here, I:1/1 here. I'm gonna right click, edit symbol, stop push button, hit enter. All right. So now I have my start and my stop. Let's go ahead and put some memory in here around my start button. Drop this around. Okay. So we want to bring this into here. It doesn't like the idea of you dragging this around. That's actually a super important feature. We'll drop a memory in here. We'll come here, and I'm just going to add a B3 to this real quick, okay? So B:0/0, enter. I'm going to drag that memory right down to there, which is another awesome feature. That can save you some serious time. Add in a new rung. Drop an input here. Drop an output. I'll drag that B3 name down here again. And then... double click here, I'm gonna do output:2/0 and hit enter. I'm gonna right click, edit description, and I'm gonna call this red light, all right? Now, if you come over to that output, so this is output two, forward slash zero. So this is that output, output to zero here. If you right click, you can actually select what color it will be. All right. So I said this was a red light. So I'll go ahead and put, I'll put that here. And now how to download it. Okay. Again, they've made this so simple. So I'm going to come here. So now what we want, what I want you to do, now we're going to go ahead and download this. So you can do this here where you select download to PLC. Okay. Which is a super cool feature. And then we need to put it into run mode. And this is different than RS Logix 500, but we can come here and show PLC control panel. And you can download it here as well. Or you, then what you have to download it. Then, so we just come here, download it. Okay. Put this into run mode. Now I'm going to come over here, hit my start button. Boom, look. And again, I know on RS Logix 500, it's typically green. Okay. But this yellow activated this right here. That yellow comes down over to here. And so here's my logical path. This is logically true here. The program works, man. It's really super cool. All right. And this will be something that we explore more over the next couple of weeks while I do this online learning thing. And we'll all get used to it. Okay. And I'm going to set up some office hours for you guys to help you out with this. All right. And, you know, we'll work through this together. All right, guys, I'm going to be here for you to answer, at least attempt to answer as many questions as I can. All right. So I will. So this is an introduction video. And so after this, we will go ahead and get into the counters things. All right. We'll see you guys soon. A little bit more on the floating head technology page. So I'll see you guys soon.